Yeah. Or maybe he can send it to us, the right tune, the right melody of the song, so that when the children will sing it again, they will sing it in the right melody and the right tune. Amen. But the lyrics is very good. Amen. Yeah, thank you, Lenny, for helping the young people to inspiring them to express what is in their heart. Amen. To write their experience through song, express it through song. You know, it's important. You know, if you study the life of David, how he wrote the whole book of Psalms. Amen. Everything he experienced in life, he expressed it through songs. Amen. All his encounters, he expressed it through songs. Hello. Not in frustration, not in tantrums, but through songs. Amen. Hey, we must know how to do that, or else that's why look at the generation today. You know, they have wrong expression of what they are experiencing in life. Amen. That's why they have problem in emotions. They have all kinds of problem emotionally. Why? Because of lack of expression. Amen. They don't know how to express. They don't know how to pour out their hearts in the right way. Amen. Instead of writing what is in their heart, expressing what is in their heart, in their mind, they turn into other things. Amen. You know, when are we listening? Yes. Praise the Lord. I'm gentle. Amen. Hey, are you here?
Yes.
Are you awake?
Amen.
You know, this is important, because when we have the right expression of what God is doing inside of our heart, it's also another way to influence the next generation. Amen. Look at the song. It's so influential that the next generation are always tuning to it. Amen. Listening to it, singing the song everywhere. Amen. But the song that we are hearing from the world is a wrong. The song that we are hearing from the world carrying wrong spirit. Amen. That's why we as a church, we must cultivate this gift that God gave to us. Amen. We must know how to cultivate it and reach it, so that we can influence our generation. You know, song can change the atmosphere. Amen. Song can change the frequency of your heart. Song is so powerful. I said song is so powerful. Amen. When you are sad, you just listen to the song and you become inspired. Hello. I don't know you, but this is what we are. Amen. When we feel something that we cannot express, then we find the right song so that we can have a full expression of what is in the inside of our heart. Amen. Hello. That's why we are so thankful to having somebody on the other side of the world helping us, to inspiring us to do something about what is in the inside of the next generation. Amen. You know, try to write everything that you feel, the thoughts that God put into your heart, into your mind. Write it down. Amen. One day it will help you. One day you will find the right expression to everything that God put into your heart. Hello. You know, one pastor said to Ishi, look at your daddy. He had so many notebooks. Maybe because he write so many things. Yeah, we need to write everything. Hello. Maybe it's not for you. It's for the next generation. Amen. Sometimes the song that we sing, it's not for us. The song that God gave to us, sometimes it's not just for us. It's for the next generation that is rising. Amen? Are you blessed? You know, the problem with the young people, they are only doing things when somebody is there. You know, I want to encourage you when after you are being inspired by Lenny, you must know how to cultivate it. Continue from what you began. Amen? Don't just start something that you stop in the middle or stop in between. You must know how to push yourselves until you see, until the water is coming out from the well. Amen? Hey, young people, are you here? Amen. Why? Because, you know, Lenny is also busy doing so many works in Singapore. Amen. You know, sometimes we just thought, oh, he's just in vacation here. No. There's also something that God put into his heart so that the next generation will know how to write songs that according to what God is doing in their lives, in their heart. Amen. And it's important for us that somebody know how to do it in the right way. Amen. Are you okay? Praise the Lord. Hello. Okay, open your Bible in the book of Acts chapter 2. When the day of Pentecost arrived, they were all together in one place. And suddenly there came from heaven a sound like a mighty rushing wind that filled the entire house where they were sitting. And are you in Acts chapter 2? When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly there came from heaven a noise like a violent rushing wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. And there appeared to them tongues as of fire, distributing themselves, and they rested on each one of them. You know, I tell you, the church is very important. Amen. When the church was born, it is born in power. I said, when the church is born, it is born in power. The church is born in the power of the Holy Ghost, in the power of the Holy Spirit. Because the church is the vehicle of God, the instrument of God, so that the kingdom of God will be advanced. I said, the church is the instrument of God, so that the kingdom of God will be advanced here on the earth. Amen. That's why this morning, we will talk about kingdom advancement. Write these things as point number one. Kingdom advancement is not the work of one, but of everyone. Kingdom advancement is not the work of one, but of everyone. Meaning we cannot do it alone. I said we cannot do it alone. We must do it together. I said we must do it together. Amen. Building one family is not building by one alone. There must be partnership. There must be covenant relationship. There must be strong bond of relationship so that the institution of family will be strong. So also the same with the church. Hey, are you listening? Sure, listening? Do you want to stand until I finish? You don't want. Don't sleep. Amen? Amen. Yung iba parang nag-drawing na ng mata na nakadilat kahit tulog. Hello. Amen. That's why for the church to advance the kingdom of God, we must understand that it is not the work of one. It is the work of everyone. That's why the Bible says when the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. They are not individually, they are not living an individual life, but they are living a corporate life. I said they are living a corporate life. That's why it's important for us to know how to work together, not just work for ourselves. Amen. Open your Bible in Acts chapter 4 and in verse 32. You know, during our conference, prayed and released some prophetic word. When Kwame come up on the stage, he showed me all his notes exactly to all that I have said. And he is so amazing. He is so trembling because he recognized that God is in our midst. Hello. In verse 32, and the congregation of those who believe were of one heart and soul. This congregation is called the church. I said this congregation is called the church. As long as the church are of one heart, then we can advance the kingdom. Are we listening? Hey, please don't do something else. Hello, don't do another thing. That's when the congregation of those who believe were of one heart. The Bible is talking about the church. Amen. The congregation must be of one heart and soul, and not one of them claim that anything belonging to him was his own, but all things were common property to them. Imagine the life that I have is not for me, it's for you. The life that you have is not for you, but it's for me too. Hello. Why? Because we must have a common life. I said we must have one life. Not having the spirit of individualism, but having the spirit of corporate life. We embrace to have a corporate life. So kingdom advancement is not the work of one, but of everyone. That's why every one of us must have the right. Every one of us must have one heart, one mind, one soul, in advancing the kingdom of God. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Point number two, we need to fast track everything because we will go somewhere. Just for this moment. Just for this week. Number two, kingdom advancement are for those who are moved by the Spirit and empowered with the Spirit. Kingdom advancement are for those who are moved by the Spirit and empowered by the Spirit. Amen? And we cannot become part of kingdom advancement if we are not moved by the Spirit. Amen? Or else you are advancing your own kingdom. Amen? That's why I look at so many people today. They go to church not to advance the kingdom, but to advance their own property, to advance their own dream. But not advancing the kingdom of God. That's why kingdom advancement are for those who are moved by the Spirit and empowered by the Spirit. That's why the empowering is important, and also the ability to move by God, not just moving by ourselves. Amen. That's why we need to know how to yield to Him, trust Him in everything we do, that we are not doing things by ourselves, but doing things because He is the one moving our life. Amen. That we are not moving. We will not move unless He move. I said we will not move unless He move. We will not turn to right unless He is the one leading us to turn to right. Amen. Why? Because kingdom advancement are for those who are moved by the Spirit. So the Bible says when the day of Pentecost arrived, they were all together in one place, and suddenly a mighty rushing wind entered into the house, and they were all filled and empowered by the Holy Spirit. So also in Acts chapter 1, before the Holy Spirit came, Jesus said to them in verse 4, gathering them together, He commanded them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait for what the Father had promised, which He said, You heard of from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit at many days from now. So when they had come together, they were asking Him, saying, Lord, is it at this time you will give me a house? No. He said to them, it is not for you to know times or season which the Father has fixed by His own authority, but you will receive power. Amen. Sometimes the only concern we have is the things of ourselves, the things for ourselves. But Jesus said, don't be concerned too much about those things, but you will receive power. Hey, what is your concern? Hello. We have so many wrong concerns. But God's concern is to empower us so that we can use us to advance the kingdom of God. That's why the concern of the disciples during the time is in the political area. Hello. They are asking our Lord Jesus Christ, when you will restore the kingdom to Israel? Why? Because they are so much concerned about the politics. Amen. When is the kingdom of Israel will be restored and taken out from the hands of the Roman Empire? That is their concern. But the concern of God is to empower them, to fill them with the Spirit, so that they can use them to advance the kingdom of God. Amen. Okay, this must be the primary concern in our heart. That's why the Bible says, seek first His kingdom and His righteousness, and all that the Gentiles are seeking will be added unto us. Amen. We have a good Father. We don't need to ask Him for food. We don't need to ask Him for clothing. Why? Because He is a good God. He is a good Father. Do we have a good Father?
Yes.
I said, do we have a good Father?
Yes.
And we don't need to ask those kind of things, because if our natural Father provide all those things, even we don't ask, how much more our Heavenly Father? I said, how much more our Heavenly Father? He is more good than our natural Father. Hello? Hey, are we listening? That's why kingdom advancement are for those who are moved by the Spirit and empowered by the Spirit. That's why we cannot become part of advancing the kingdom of God until we are moved by the Spirit, until the Holy Spirit, until we know how to be moved by Him. Not just moving Him, but He is the one moving us. Amen. That's why we don't need to exert much effort to see the move of God. Just move with Him. I said, just move with Him. We don't need to sing 10 songs for Him to come down. Just learn how to follow and yield to Him. Surely God will manifest. I said, surely God will manifest. Amen. That's why Jesus said to them, it is not for you to know times and season that the Father has fixed by His own authority. Amen. There are things that is already fixed that we cannot change. Amen. Like the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Surely He will come. We don't know when, where, how, but surely He will come because it's already fixed. Who knows when He will come? Only the Father. That's why we don't need to put so much concern of those things, because God already fixed that time. But His concern is how He will empower us, how He will baptize us with the Holy Spirit, so that we will know how to live in the Spirit, so that we know how to live by Him, move by Him, and He can guide us and bring us into all that He plans and purpose into our life. Amen. That's why the Bible, Jesus said, it's not for you to know times and seasons which the Father has fixed by His own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. Amen. This is the lacking in so many Christians, the empowering of the Holy Spirit. That's why what they are advancing is their own kingdom. Amen. They're always projecting that, oh, I am blessed because I go to church, I have this, I have that, I buy this and I buy that, I go to Dubai and buy. Hello. They thought they are advancing. I go into this expensive restaurant and to glorify God. No, it's not glorifying God, you're glorifying yourself. You know, sometimes, you know, people posting all kinds of things on Facebook just to project themselves that they are doing this, doing that, having this and having that for God's glory. I don't know who is glorified. if we will boast, we must boast in the Lord that He is working in our life, not just blessing us on material things, but He is really that we are really impacting lives, changing lives, and bringing and snatching souls from hell. Hello, are you listening? It's my kingdom advancement are for those who are moved by the Spirit. That's why if we want to become part of the advancement of the kingdom of God, then we must know how to be moved by Him. Amen. Sure, making sure that the Holy Spirit is the one moving our life, and He is the one empowering us. Amen. I said He is the one empowering us. Point number three. I talked to one Australian. I say something, and he said, "What's the point?" This is the point. sometimes some people they small things they want to make it big. Small things is small things. Don't use magnifying glass to make it look so big, even though it's so tiny. Hello. When people have wrong spirit, small things become big, big things become small. Just allow the Holy Spirit to speak to us and guide us in all ways, in all our ways. Number three, kingdom advancement. Kingdom advancement is building Him a house. Kingdom advancement is building Him a house to dwell, a place to manifest His glory. Kingdom advancement is building Him a house. Building Him a house to dwell, a place to manifest His glory. The reason why God commanded Moses to build the tabernacle so that he can have a place to dwell and manifest His glory. That's why the church is important, because the church is the house of God. I said the church is the house of God. Every time we gather together, we are in-housing Him. I said we are in-housing Him. I think it's in 1 Peter. Open your Bible in 1 Peter. First Peter chapter 2. Verse 4. I'm coming to Him as to a living stone. That's why every time we come to Him, become a living stone, not dead stone. Hello, so many people inside the church are dead stone. They don't carry life. Hello. Do you carry life? Are you alive?
Yes.
So every time we come together, we must become a living stone, not a dead stone. Meaning we carry the life of God. Amen. We carry the life of the Spirit. And coming to Him as a living stone, which has been rejected by men, but is choice and precious in the sight of God. You also as living stone. Amen. He is the living stone. Jesus is the living stone. He is the precious stone. He is the choice stone. Amen. He is the cornerstone. He is the foundation stone. In verse 5, you also. That's why if He is the living stone, we must also become a living stone. Amen. That's why if He is rejected by man, we also experiencing it. But God has chosen us. I said, but God has chosen us. Like our Lord Jesus Christ, but is choice and precious in the sight of God. In verse 5, you also as living stone are being built up as a spiritual house for a holy priesthood to offer up spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. Amen. That's why this is important for us to understand that as we come together, we are in-housing God. We are building Him a house to dwell so that His glory will manifest. Imagine when we come together, the Holy Spirit will come down, God will come down, Jesus will come down, so that those who have need those who have needs will be met, so that those who are sick will be healed. Hello, those who are dying will come to life. Hello, are you listening?
Yes.
Amen. Why? Imagine God dwells in us. That every time we come together, He chooses to dwell within our midst. He chooses to dwell in our midst. Just imagine it. Surely nothing will be impossible. I said, surely nothing will be impossible. Why? Because He is with us. He is in our midst. Amen. Imagine just the shadow of Peter can raise people from the dead, can bring healing to those who are sick. How much more He Himself will be in our midst? I said, how much more He Himself is in our midst? Surely all things will be possible. Amen. There will be no hard things. There will be no difficult things in our midst. Why? Because He is with us. Amen. That's why kingdom advancement is building Him a house to dwell, a place to manifest His glory. That's why every time we come together, we must become a living stone. We must become a company of people that know how to build Him a house to dwell. Build Him a house to operate with, so that the kingdom of darkness will be no longer operating in our city, in our family, in every place that we are going. We are destroying all the works of hell. Amen. Open your Bible in the book of Ezra chapter 1. Ezra chapter 1. The Bible says, in the first year of Cyrus, king of Persia, in order to fulfill the word of the Lord by the mouth of Jeremiah the prophet, the Lord stirred up the spirit of Cyrus, king of Persia, so that he proclamation throughout all of his kingdom, and also put it in writing. That's why kingdom advancement, like what I have said in point number 2, are for those who are moved by the Spirit, those who are stirred by the Spirit. And kingdom advancement is building Him a house to dwell, a place to manifest His glory. That's why those who are stirred by the Spirit of God, they are commanded to build Him a house. Amen? Amen. That's why the stirring of the Spirit is not just for you to have material things. The stirring of the Spirit is for you to become the house of God so that He can dwell. Amen? That must be our foremost desire. Amen? That we want Him to dwell in our life. We want Him to be His house. Why God stir up Cyrus so that Cyrus can command all the people of Israel to go back to Jerusalem to build God a house in Jerusalem. Amen. So that God's glory will be restored. Amen. So that God's glory will be restored, so that the glory of the nation will also be restored. Amen. Because if the God is restored in the nation, surely the glory of the nation will also be restored. Amen. You know, before Philippines are so powerful in Asia, we are richer than Malaysia before. That's our glory before. Okay, some of you, because you are just born, I don't know today. Amen. But that's the history. That's our story before, but God will. But I believe God will restore our glory. I said God will restore our glory. Hey, we are richer than Malaysia. We are richer than some nation in Southeast Asia. But look at what happened to us now. But I believe when God is restored, when the church is restored in the nation, the glory of the nation will also be restored too. Amen. Point number 4, kingdom advancement or for those who know how to inspire others and encourage others to go to the next level. Kingdom advancement are for those who know how to inspire others and encourage others to go to the next level. That's why if we want to advance the kingdom of God, we must know how to inspire others. Not discourage them, but inspire them. Amen? But if your voice is not good, I don't know how to inspire you to sing. It's deep. You know, that's why during the conference, so many, Pastor Roy had a good voice. Pastor Stephen too. I almost want to say, may nanalo na. I don't know how to sing. I'm the worst one. I lose. I lose the competition. But this is very important. How to inspire one another. I said how to inspire one another. Open your Bible in Acts chapter 4. See how these people inspire one another to go to the next level. In verse, okay, let's read verse 32. And the congregation of those who believe were of one heart and soul, and not one of them claimed that anything belonging to him was his own, but all things were common property to them. And with great power the apostles were giving testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and abundant grace was upon them all. For there was not a needy person among them. For all who were owners of land or houses would sell them and bring the proceeds of the sales and lay them at the apostles' feet, and they would be distributed to each as any had need. Now Joseph, a Levite of Cyprian birth, who was also called Barnabas by the apostles, which translated means son of encouragement. Are you son of encouragement? And who owned a tract of land, sold it and brought it the money and laid it at the apostles' feet. And he became the inspiration to all. Hello, because of what he did. Something we must do that people will become encouraged. People become inspired to go to the next level. Amen. Hello. Do something that will inspire them. Amen. Don't do something that will discourage the next generation. Amen. Like show them how you serve God with all your heart, so that they will be inspired too to serve God with all their hearts too. Amen. And because you inspire them, they will desire to go to the next level. Amen. Hindi yung di ko maten sila rin, di na rin natin. Ikaw nga eh. Hello. Hey, don't bring discouragement to others. Amen. But bring inspiration. That's why if we want to become part of kingdom advancement, we must be a company of people who know how to inspire others and encourage others to go to the next level. The last point, we're very fast. Some of you, I wish every week they will go somewhere so that we always finish early. Only for this week. Next week, we will finish 2 p.m. No, I'm just joking. Huh? Babawi ako next week. Okay, point number 5. This will be our last point. Kingdom advancement must be for the purpose of bringing heaven down here on the earth. Kingdom advancement must be for the purpose of bringing heaven down here on the earth. Why we advance the kingdom? So that heaven will be here on the earth. I said so that heaven will be here on the earth. Why? Because it's not our kingdom, it is God's kingdom. It's not our rule, it is God's rule. Amen. So that he can make the earth like heaven. Hello. He can rule the earth like he ruled the heaven. Hello. Hey, that must be our mindset. in advancing the kingdom because we want to see heaven here on the earth. Amen. That all the corruption, all the things that is wrong will become right. Hello. All the things that the devil has ruined will be restored back into the original. So that the days of heaven will be here on the earth. Amen. Hey, do you imagine that one day what is in heaven will be on the earth? That's why Jesus prayed, "Your kingdom come, let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven." Even our Lord Jesus Christ desired that heaven will be here on the earth. Hello, that how God ruled the whole heaven will be the same thing that will happen here on the earth. Amen. In the natural we don't see, but in the spirit He ruled the whole, not only the heaven but also the earth. But one day it will not just be in the spirit realm, it will be manifest in the natural. Amen. That every sickness and disease will be gone. I said every sickness and disease will be gone. All the corruption will be gone. All the poverty will be gone. All the violence will be gone. Why? Because heaven is now coming down here on the earth. Imagine during the times of Wales revival, Wales in England, not Wales on the sea. Hello, some of you, I don't know what you understand. During the Wales revival in England, you know, all the hospitals are closed. There's nobody on the prison cell. Hello? Why? Because it's like the days of heaven here on the earth. No violence on the street. No street children, because all the Christians adopted those who don't have parents. Hello? They are the one bringing them to the school. They are the one in housing them. Imagine, no sickness, no violence. The police has no job. Doctor has no job. Why? Because it's like the days of heaven here on the earth. Hey, that's the revival that we are waiting for. That one day, no sickness, no disease, no violence, no corruption. Why? Because heaven is established here on the earth. Because the kingdom of God is established. Surely it will happen in the days to come. That's why we are not just waiting for us to go to heaven, we are pressuring heaven to come down here on the earth. Hey, that must be our desire. Or else we are just waiting for our time to die and go to heaven. But we are working. Are you working? Hey, we are working. We are praying, we are working until we see the kingdom of God is advanced. For what purpose? So that heaven will be here on the earth. Amen. That's the reason why God commanded Moses to build the tabernacle so that he can have a place to dwell. So that, imagine, for 40 years, nobody is sick. Hello. I said nobody is sick in the wilderness. Nobody experienced, even though they experienced they are bitten by scorpion or serpent, but they will just look on the piece of wood. Hello, that there's a sign of snake. Image of the snake. Di ba alam yung logo ng mga ng medical, ha? Di ba yung may snake na, hello, they just look on that image and they are healed. Imagine how God protected them. Amen. Yung their clothing, diba, yung damit nila hindi naluluma, yung sapatos nila hindi naluluma for 40 years. Why? Because God dwells within them. No need, no poverty. Even though they don't have proper education, and yet they are the most advanced. Hello. In technology. I tell you, these things will happen when God dwells in our midst. Amen. But for some people, they thought, oh, how it will happen? Hey, read the Bible. They have the best craftsmen. They have all the golds. They have all the things that they need. They have manna from heaven. They have water from the rock. Hello. Why? Because God dwell in the midst of them. That's why the purpose of kingdom advancement must be for the purpose of bringing down heaven here on the earth. Let's all stand this morning and let's thank the Lord. Please, maybe we are very fast, but put seriously these things into your heart. Hello? I said put this thing seriously in your heart, that we must become one. I said we must become one. We must know how to work together. Amen. Don't allow yourself to, don't isolate yourself. Isolation is very dangerous. Hello? I said isolation is very dangerous. That's why so many people commit suicide, because they isolate themselves. People become depressed, oppressed, because they isolate themselves. And all kinds of demonic possession happen when people start to isolate themselves, because they don't want to work with anyone. They want to do things alone. But kingdom advancement is not the work of one man. It's the work of everyone. Amen? So kingdom advancement are for those who are moved by the Spirit. That's why always consider the Holy Spirit in your life before you do something. Amen? Ask Him. I said ask Him. That's why the Bible says if you ask, you will receive. Amen? Do you want to receive?
Yes.
I said, do you want to receive?
Yes.
Then learn how to ask. I said, learn how to ask. Do you want to find? Then learn how to seek. I said, learn how to seek. All these things is for us to continually knowing how to trust Him and put our faith in Him. It's not just about fundamental or basic thing. You cannot go to the next level unless you master the basic first. Hello, you cannot go to grade, to intermediate grade, intermediate, unless you go first to primary, and in that place we learn all the basics, because that's our foundation to go to the next level. So I will repeat it again. Do you want to find? Then learn how to seek. Do you want to receive? Then learn how to ask. Do you want the door to be open? Then learn how to knock. Meaning, do some extra effort. Exert some effort. So that you, why? Because faith without works is dead.
Hello.
Learn how to work out your faith by exerting some effort. Learn how to knock until the door is open. Amen? That's why the Holy Spirit must empower us. Amen? And one of the work of the Holy Spirit is to put the right thoughts in our mind, in our heart, so that we can ask the right thing, so that we can receive the right thing.
Hello?
Amen? The work of the Holy Spirit is to guide us to the right door, so that when we knock that door, the right opportunity will be open to us, not the wrong one. Because not every door is for you to open. Some people, they open the wrong door and all hell break loose into their life. That's why it is the Holy Spirit that will guide you into the right door for you to knock, so that the right door will be open to you. Because if you open the wrong door, if you knock the wrong door, all hell will break loose to your life. Amen? That's why don't seek the wrong thing.
Hello?
That's why it is the Holy Spirit that will put the right desire into your heart to seek for the right thing. Amen? So that you will never go wrong. Amen? And kingdom advancement is to build him a house. That's why every time we come together, we become the house of God. Amen? We become his house so that he can use each one of us to advance his kingdom. And kingdom advancement are those for those who know how to inspire one another, meaning always become inspiration to everyone, not a discouragement. Amen? Always become the pattern, the right example. I said, become the right example.
Yes.
Are you the right example?
Yes.
In everything we do, we must become the right example to everyone, and so that we become encouragement. Amen? And the last thing that God wants to put into our heart, we are here to bring heaven down here on the earth. I said, we're here to bring down heaven here on the earth. I tell you, the revival that they experienced before cannot be compared to the revival that God wants to do in our time. The latter glory of this house, the former glory of this house will be greater. Hello. Than greater the things that he will do in our time. That's why I believe we must look forward to greater things, not to the worst one. You know, look at so many churches today, they are looking for the worst thing, looking forward for the worst thing that will happen. That there will be flood, there will be earthquake, there will be fire, there will be all kinds of disaster. Although those things will happen, surely, but we are not looking for it. We're looking for glorious day. I said we are looking for glorious day. That's why look at so many Christians, they don't want to do anything anymore because they think everything will end. Why we are doing these things? Because they are looking for dooms and glooms, but we are looking for heaven.
Amen.
Here on the earth.
Yes.
That's why we are working hard to build the church.
Amen.
We are working hard to build each one of us, building one another. We are working hard to pray for one another.
Amen.
and bring one another into the next level of our maturity. Amen. Why? Because we are looking for glorious day.
Amen.
Amen. We are looking for better future.
Amen.
Amen, that all our children will be the one using by God, putting them in the right position so that the nation will be built, so that the nation will enter into his glorious day. Amen, because every nation belongs to God. I said every nation belongs to God. Every government one day will be run by the sons and daughters of God. Amen, that's why you know, some Christians, they don't want to send their children anymore to the school because they thought, oh, Jesus will come back soon, the devil will destroy all the whole earth, why we send our children to the school? But for us, it's different. We send our children to the best school because one day we know all our children will be used by God to run the government.
Yes.
I said to run the government,
yes.
To run every institution, and we will see a better day.
Amen.
I said we will see a better day.
Amen.
Better future.
Amen.
Glorious future.
Amen.
Amen. Father, we thank you this afternoon. We thank you, Lord God, for what you are doing in our lives.
Yes.
That all together we will work as one to advance the kingdom of God.
Yes.
We thank you, Lord, for knitting our hearts and making us more and more one in this place.
Yes.
Not only in this place, but also those whom you are sending here. So that we can work together, maybe in a different way, but at the end of the day, it's for the advancement of your kingdom.
Amen.
We thank you, Lord God. I pray for your blessing to each one of us in this place. Bless every family. Bless all the works of their hands. Father, I pray right now that even those who are sick will be healed.
Yes.
Though every health will be restored.
Yes.
And every wealth, oh Lord God, will multiply. so that we can use it to advance your kingdom here on the earth, so that we can touch many lives, so that we can change many lives, influence the next generation. We thank you, Lord God, even for Lenny. Thank you for sending him here to inspire the next generation to have the right expression through songs. I pray for your blessing upon his life and his family and all the things that he is doing in the nation of Singapore. Bless him, O Lord, that we pray that as he go back, O Lord God, he will begin to see, Lord God, all the needs, O Lord God, that the church in Singapore that need to rise, O Lord God, and he will be the one, you will be the one using him as an instrument to stand, O Lord God, so that the church will become strong and protected from all the attacks of the enemy. Thank you, Lord. Bless him, bless his children, his wife, and all the things that he is doing. Thank you, Lord. Lord God, as we travel to Bulacan this afternoon, we pray, Lord God, that you will do an amazing things in our life. To those who will present, Lord God, they use their lives, O Lord. Lord, we are not leaning on our own strength. We are not trusting our own talent, but Lord, it's you that we trust. We cannot do it without you. We have no strength to do it. But by your Spirit, O Lord, we know we can bring impact and bring change into the atmosphere, even to the lives of those who will attend that meeting. Lord, even we know even how much we practice, still it is the Holy Spirit. It is you that will do great things. Lord, help us that every move that they will take manifest your glory, Lord. That not us that we will be seen, but your grace will be the one that will be seen by the people. Lord, bless all the young people that will go with us. Lord, that the first thing that they will mind off is not how they will show it to the people, but how they will glorify your name. Lord, I pray, O Lord God, that not only them that they will change, but also first that you will change us first. You will make us more and more yielded to you and know how to trust you in everything we do. Because we know it's not by might or by power, but by your Spirit that works within us. Thank you, Lord. We bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen, amen. Okay, God bless you. Wait for some announcement.
What fortune lies beyond the stars? Those dazzling hearts too fast to